Hello everyone, this is Catherine and welcome back to my channel. Maraming maraming salamat po. Muchísimas gracias. Thank you very much for subscribing and watching my video. Words cannot express how much I love and appreciate all of you. I'll be forever grateful because look at this one. We have now 500 subscribers. Maraming maraming salamat po. Okay, so today we are going to talk about the telling the time in Spanish. ¿Qué hora es? What time is it? ¿Anong oras na? So we are going to discuss how to answer this question in Spanish. ¿Qué hora es? Okay, so as you can see, I listed trilingual so that everybody can understand Spanish, English, and Filipino o Tagalog. So let's start. Okay, es la una in English, it's 1 o'clock. In Filipino, a la una, as you can see, we are similar with the Spanish. Look. A la una, es la una. And then, son las dos, it's 2 o'clock. In Filipino, a las dos. Okay, I will discuss later what is the difference between es and son and la and las. Okay, son las tres, it's 3 o'clock, a las tres. Son las cuatro, it's 4 o'clock, a las cuatro. As you can see, Filipino and Spanish, we have the same pronunciation but different in spelling. So in Castellano, they have letter C in cuatro. But in our word in Tagalog, we have K. So cuatro, but we pronounce the same in Castellano. Son las cinco. It's 5 o'clock, a las cinco. So same also with cinco, we have letter S. In Castellano, they have letter C, and then letter C, and then we change it from K, but we add NG here, cinco. Okay, next, son las seis. It's 6 o'clock, a las seis in Tagalog. Okay, son las siete. It's 7 o'clock. A las siete. Son las ocho. It's 8 o'clock. A las ocho. Son las nueve. It's 9 o'clock. A las nueve. So as you can see, again, the spelling, but it's the same pronunciation. But we change the V into letter B. Instead of nueve, we pronounce it nueve. And also we have W added here. In Spanish, U-E, and then we added W after U, in between U and E. Son las diez. It's 10 o'clock. A las diez. So, same, again, different spelling. And then son las once, it's 11 o'clock. A las once. Son las doce, it's 12 o'clock. A las doce. So I hope that you learned the Spanish way how to tell time, and also not only in Spanish, in English, and of course, Filipino, if you do not know our language. So sometimes, actually, here in Spain, when people ask me what time is it, I normally mixed the Filipino term. I always use ala, alas, 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 and they do not have that word here because I am used to say it in Philippines. So until now, I'm almost 2 years here in Spain, and I barely say a las dos, a la una, a las tres, so that's the reason. Anyways, let's practice Next, okay, so as what I am telling before, okay, what is S and why we say in Spanish es la una? Okay, it is very simple because one is singular. Okay, so S is the verb be in English. In castellano, verbo estar. So in English, we say it's 1 o'clock. Our verb in English is is. And in English, they do not change the verb from 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. It's the same. But in Spanish, they do change the verb. So like, for example, one is es la una because that is singular. It's 1 o'clock, but in, but 2, 3, 4 up to 12 o'clock, that is plural. So they change the verb. This is the verb son, verbo estar. The verb be means are in English. So they change it because 2 and the rest of the number, I mean up to 12, is plural. So they say son las dos. Okay. So what is that? What is la? Es la una. What is la? La in Spanish is the article. So in Spanish they have this rule: babae lalaki. In English, masculine and feminine. So they always do that in their, I mean, in their sentences. They put article. So es la una because it's feminine, feminino, because we are talking about hora. ¿A qué hora es? Means that word is feminine, femenino, babae. So they change the article into, not change, use the article la. La una, because that refers to the word hora, meaning feminine. Okay, that is why es la una, because if that, if we are talking about masculine, for example, we say uno. So uno is masculine. So you cannot say la es el uno. No, because hora is femenino. So that is why they say it es la una, because of the feminine thing in the word. And then here in the example, it's 2 o'clock. Son las dos. Okay, what happened here? The article la, because it's plural, we also add s. That is why son las dos, son las tres, or son las doce. So that is the reason why we put s and son. Maybe the the next video I'm going to discuss about the verbs also in Spanish, so that you will use to it to learn about also these verbs, because this is very important. And the article, because if that is for feminine, they put la, and then if that is for masculine, they put el. For example, el hombre, because that is like the man. So in English, the man. But if that's a girl, it's the girl, la mujer or la chica. So they change the article. Pambabae o panlalaki in Tagalog. Okay, so I hope that you understand this es and son. Okay, again, es and son is the verb be in English. Is and are, because and then in Spanish they called it verbo estar. And then all because in English they do not change the verb from 1 o'clock, it's 1 o'clock, it's 2 o'clock, it's the same verb. But in Spain, I mean in Spanish rather, they change, but that is the only, that is for 1 o'clock, that's the only time that they change, because it's singular. Okay, so now let's go to vocabulary in minutes. Vocabulario. So each number, we count this as 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60 in English. But in Spanish, okay, letter Y, they pronounce it E. E means end in English. So 5 minutes means E cinco, for example. Son las 12 y 5. In English, we normally say it 12:05. Or we will just say it's 5 past 12. So we have different, I mean, in English, there's a lot of ways how to say the time. And then y 10, y cuarto, because this is a quarter. So y cuarto. And then y 20, y 25, y media, and then menos 25, menos 20, menos cuarto, menos 10, menos 5 en punto. Okay, so from 1 to 6, we normally use the word here past. Okay, in English, past. So, for example, it's 11:30 if the long arms of the clock is here. Okay, or we can also say that 11:30. But in Tagalog is, I mean, we la misma in Castellano. We said it a las 11:30. But the only difference is we have a la. We don't have the verb. Es la una o son las dos. In Filipino, we just say a la una, a las dos, a las tres, a las cuatro. Okay? And then from 7 to 12, we use the word to here in English, like 25 minutes to 12, for example. No? And then here, past. But in English, in Spanish, as you can see the word here, menos, meaning here you need to subtract, to put minus. Here you need to add 5, 10, 15, but here you are going to put menos. For example, this one, son las 12 menos 25. Or in English, we will just say that 25 minutes before 12. And also, the other way, it's 11:35. So that is the difference of telling the time in Spanish. We will just say, okay, for example, if the long arm is here, you will just say 12 menos cuarto or quarter to 12. Okay, so I hope that you learned some vocabulary words here, okay? So now let's practice. As you can see, I have here, mira los relojes. ¿Y qué hora es? So number one, as you can see, las tres y media. ¿Vale? Las tres y media. We say this the same in Tagalog, but we put a las tres y media. That's the only different. We put a las. Here, add a in last, the article. So, number two, las dos menos cuarto. And number three, las diez y cuarto. Okay, and then number four, la una. Okay, again, la una. So now I want you to answer 5 and 6. And I want you to put your answer in the comment and let's see if you got the correct answer. Again, thank you so much and do not forget to like and subscribe. Paalam, hanggang sa muli, hasta luego, hasta lo próximo video. Bye!